Welcome to sunny Winter Haven, Florida. I'm Lane Dog Bowers, and today I want to talk to you about the truth about barefoot shorts. I just want to shoot out a quick email about this. Sometimes I forget all my experience the last 25 years. There's still a lot of people out there who just don't know the truth about it. And here's an example. I took this email. I cut out the person's last name and email address so that in case they didn't want me to give that information away. But it says, "Hey, Lane, trying to get thick shorts so I can get to doing some of the long line stuff besides deep water up and with a wake crossing. Are they shipping yet?" By the way, yes, we are shipping. All my orders are getting out right now, so that is not a problem. And we're getting them out extremely quickly. So yeah, we've been very fortunate that way. Do they restrict anything? In other words, do these thicker shorts they're asking restrict? I'm asking because a few footers said, as you get better, the shorts should become thinner. In fact, I borrowed a pair this weekend that were not much thicker than 1-2 millimeters. Second question, also on shorts for Father's Day, he's our footing dad. A few of us were going to get him a new pair of shorts. His are very thin, and the other pair is even thinner. They're both Eagle brand. On your site, you have one short, so I ask about a competitor, but it may be the only option. Okay, this is a great question, and I want to give you a little bit of history about it and the truth about it. The truth about the shorts is I probably was one of, other than Mike Seipel, I was probably the first top barefooter in the world who was wearing full padded shorts when everyone was going thinner and thinner, paper thin. I remember Ron Scarpa was testing out these suits that were literally as thin as my t-shirt. They had the teeniest, maybe, you know, 1-2 mil of, I don't know if it, 1-3 at the very most padding on the butt. And it was super crazy thin. And the idea was if you're better barefoot, you really don't need protection. But that myth got busted. And I was like the first guy to wear full Iron Man Barefoot International shorts under my barefoot suit. And honestly, people laughed at me. They thought I was, you know, only beginners do that or something like that, until they saw that I had an unfair advantage. And this is for time. You know, my passion is to share what works for beginners and intermediates. But as a top barefooter, I had an unbelievable advantage in jumping, in flips, in starts. And that came from having tons of protection, not less protection, more protection. And like I say, it was unbelievable. When people realized how much the shorts helped, for instance, in jumping and landing, there, I don't think there's a top guy in the world now who wouldn't wear Iron Man shorts underneath their barefoot suit. And here's the deal. On our shorts, our Iron Man barefoot shorts, these things are 23, just like our barefoot suit, are 23 mil of padding. All the way, not just on the hamstrings and the butt, but all the way around your hips. And it's 23 millimeter of padding, two sets of glue. So it is the most protection and the most comfortable short you can wear. Does it restrict you? Absolutely does not restrict you. I remember even Mike Seipel privately told me when I first started promoting his stuff and I came from Eagle, and he said, "Lane, I understand if you got to wear like a thinner suit or something, in competition, but I really want you to promote our stuff." And I said, "Mike, I'm not promoting your stuff unless I wear your stuff, and I'm not promoting your stuff unless it helps me." And it was the best move I ever made. So to answer your question, the world's best barefoot shorts are the Barefoot International Iron Man shorts that we sell on our site. It's why it's the only short that I sell on this site. That's why it is, and we guarantee that it will make you barefoot better immediately when you put them on. You will not believe the, why are they that thick? Especially if our suit's that thick. You got to be kidding me. A lot of people are like, "I definitely don't need that. If your suit's good, then I just need the suit and I don't need the shorts." The truth is that when you sit on the water in our suit and shorts, the combination is unbelievable. That's why you see I can teach people at such slow speeds, because it doesn't matter if you're 50 pounds or 400 pounds, I can get you gliding on the water, sitting comfortably, balanced, spray out of your face at around 25 to 28 miles an hour. You can't do that with less padding and thinner shorts. It just can't be done. And then if you do wear thinner shorts, your whole thing is you want to get up as fast as you can. And when you're learning, that's not the best way to do it. Even when you're not learning, it is so comfortable to be able to get up in comfort and protection and not have to worry about water damage, your butt. A lot of people make mistakes just simply because they don't want to be on their butt. And so they rush and then their form gets bad. So the bottom line is, this is the reason why I promote the Barefoot International Ironman suit and Ironman shorts. Ironman shorts by themselves, even if you have a different Barefoot suit, is going to remarkably improve the suit you have. The combination of the Barefoot International Ironman shorts and the Barefoot International Ironman suit is unbelievable. And I guarantee it's the world's best Barefoot suit and the world's best Barefoot shorts, or I'd buy them back. So anyway, that's the tip I wanted to give you guys today. You guys deserve to be safe. You deserve to be able to barefoot slowly. And you deserve to be able to do all the barefoot tricks that you're excited about and that you want to make goals for. So that's the information. That's the facts about barefoot shorts and suits. God bless you guys and have a great day.